All right, so I guess we're on the air. It's June 23rd, Two Oceans 12, for those of you keeping notes. We're trying our hand at a podcast type thing. We'll put it on YouTube, the audio with a silly picture on it, and then we'll also have an audio download for people who don't want to sit and listen to audio on YouTube for an hour or however long this goes. Hopefully no more than an hour.
I want Harrison Ford to be in the picture.
We can look into Harrison Ford being the picture. Anyway, this is, I should probably introduce what this is, 30 seconds into what we're doing. This is ISUXDIX Loves Movies, or ISUXDIX Heart Cinema, whichever doesn't get us sued by Doug Benson, because we're just basically ripping off his thing, because we love it, if you don't know of it.
Oh, yeah, Doug's never ripped anything off.
Yeah, Doug never ripped anything off. So, yeah, if you don't know what it is, go to iTunes in the podcast, look up Doug Loves Movies, and you'll know what we're talking about. Doug Benson is a comedian we enjoy who has a podcast about movies and talk about movies and then play games. I wish we had video right now because we are in... Oh, we should probably say who we are, too. I'm Scott Hansen. We got a certain Drew Smith over here.
Hi.
And we got a certain Kelly Summers to my left. Noticeable by their absence, Justin Chu, currently in New Hampshire, because of his love for maple syrup. He accidentally went to New Hampshire instead of Vermont, where they actually have the maple syrup, and also forgot that Canada, anywhere in Canada, has better maple syrup than Vermont. So bad move, Justin Chu. Also noticeable by his absence, Daniel Fedak, because he is a sodomite. The reason I said I wish we had video is because we are in Drew Smith's bedroom, which the walls are littered, for lack of a better term, with DVDs. They're everywhere. If there's any doubt that Drew loves movies, come to his room, spend some time, do what you want, and you will see exactly why Drew's life is in the toilet.
Guy's got everything. He's got Jeepers Creepers too.
He's currently holding up a DVD copy of Chud.
This is the creme de la creme right here. This is what you need to have.
Cannibalistic humanoid underground dweller.
Is that the cream of the crop, or is it your two copies of Caligula?
It's the two copies of Caligula. Now, is it straight up just a double of it, or is one like a director's cut or a special edition?
One is the R-rated cut, and then the other one is the unrated director's cut that has trannies and hermaphrodites and DJs and midgets and all the good stuff you look for in a movie.
Now, why are you hanging on to the non-interesting
movie? I don't know, in the closet somewhere. Once I realized I bought the wrong copy.
Speaking of in the closet somewhere, as we said, Daniel Fedak will not be joining us tonight.
I can't wait till he listens to this.
I hope he never does.
I hope he does. I hope he does. I seem to recall you when you first bought Caligula. You were pretty excited to go home.
Throw a party, or
he was pretty excited to go home and see it. And I remember actually talking to you on the phone, and you was like, "Oh, we're at Al's doing something," and he's like, "You guys coming?" And Drew was like, "Fuck that! I need to get home so I can see Helen Mirren get finger banged."
Helen Mirren is the most attractive woman over the age of 50, 60, and 70.
I can't agree.
I can't agree. I can't disagree. She's a handsome woman. So now it's time for Watch This, Not That. The number one movie in America right now is Madagascar 3, Ghost Protocol, which is the third in the series of children's movies I don't care about. The number two movie in America is Prometheus, and I've been told there are two types of people in the world. People who have seen Prometheus and people who haven't been disappointed by Prometheus yet. So watch Moonrise Kingdom and not Madagascar 3 or Prometheus. This has been Watch This, Not That. Speaking of which, we have all seen Moonrise Kingdom.
Yeah.
I thought it was delightful. You? Either of you?
Oh, you want to reverse here?
Just talk.
Don't discuss.
It was fine.
I'm not the biggest Wes Anderson fan, though, but there's nothing wrong with it. Although, I mean, we all know what my problem, not what the movie was, but what the theater was.
Other extenuating circumstances notwithstanding.
Oh, shit, look, it's Paul Rudd! Oh, it's Paul Rudd, he's gonna be good!
So, a guy walks into the theater, I'm not telling, this isn't like the setup for a joke, this is a story. Guy walks into the theater with, it was his mom?
I think it's mom, probably, or
at least an older female handler.
Or he just...
And they sit, like, at least 2 seats apart.
Oh, he might have got a really bad deal on an escort service.
he got the raw end of that, if that was the case.
He's calling Golden Girls escort agency.
Yeah, so it sat down and during the beginning of the trailers, and he's, considering he's, like, not with his friends or anything, he's pretty vocal.
Yeah. Overly vocal.
Yeah.
For a movie.
And first we thought he was just kind of being a jackass. Because, like, there was the thing with Paul, what was the movie with Paul Rudd? Do we have any idea?
It was some horseshit movie about it was some Paul Rudd trying to bang somebody.
Yeah, Paul Rudd trying to fuck.
Yeah, I don't know what it was.
So, and the guy goes, and it really sounded like he was just being a jackass, and just like, hey, look, it's like really, like, almost sarcastically excited. Hey, look, it's Paul Rudd! But, how about it? And I got a rule. I give, everyone gets all the leeway they want during the trailers. Get it out of your system during the trailers. During the movie, shut the fuck up. Because I'm watching the movie. He didn't.
No.
Get it out of the system. And, the I don't know. I don't, how long was it for you guys before you figured out, oh, wait, he has mental problems?
It was pretty soon.
It was 10 minutes for me.
As soon as he started talking in the movie.
And they're like, oh.
And, like, laughing at the things that weren't jokes.
Laughing at the things that nobody was laughing at, nor were intended to be laughed at.
And he made odd comments like, this is so endearing, and like, it's just a guy sitting at a boat or something.
Yeah, it's weird, because like, for a guy, I don't know what it was, he didn't have Down syndrome, like, he looked like a human, but, yeah, I don't know what his deal was, but like, he had vocabulary, and like, he seemed to understand everything, but he just couldn't shut the fuck up.
You know what it reminded me of afterwards was that episode of It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia where Sweet D is dating Reach Butler.
Yeah, like, yeah.
Secretly he's a rap genius.
Yeah, like,
but
yeah,
he goes to short bus and high school.
Mystery as to whether he's actually retarded or, in fact, a millionaire rapper. He could be either. Yeah, he was that guy. So, yeah, that was interesting. I thought, yeah, the movie, though, that I listened to in parts between that guy adding weird commentary to it. I thought it was really good. I thought Bill Murray angry is always hilarious.
Mm-hmm. Agree.
Especially when he throws his shoe. And I thought Willis was really good. And I thought, and the kid, the boy, looked nothing like him, but sounded and like had the mannerisms exactly of Manny from Modern Family.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah,
for sure. I think my problem with it, like I said, when we after you're watching it, is Wes Anderson trying to convince us that we are interested in children now? Because they were
this was
a little too sexy in that movie.
This was a social commentary movie, right?
Yeah. There's social commentary on Wes Anderson wanting to lower the legal age of consent to 15 or lower.
I think the kids were 12 and 13.
12 and 13? Oh,
yeah.
Terrible.
It was spicy. What did I say? Because yeah, there, for those who haven't seen it, and I'm sure a bunch of people haven't seen it, there's a scene with a boy and a girl, sort of a boy from camp and a girl who lives on the island where the camp is, kind of run away together. And they like, make out and stuff. But then they share a tent together, and they're in their underwear, and something's a little uncomfortable about it.
They're romantically dancing on the beach.
Yeah.
And then making out. And then doesn't she ask?
They're not really making out. They're kids, right? They don't know what it is.
They're a tongue. She said, you know what?
Yeah, but it wasn't like so graphic or anything like that.
I'm pretty sure that I saw her grab his junk and say, is it hard?
I don't remember that either.
I could have sworn that happened.
You may
have. Are you watching? Maybe I was hoping that.
Here's my eyewitness testimony is bad, because I don't think that happened at all. I think you completely added that.
Maybe I'm just confusing with my kingdom of Tokyo. I don't know. Maybe.
But yeah, I think when they went into the tent in their underwear, did I turn to you and say, I'm supposed to be turned on, right?
Yeah. We're supposed to be turned on by him? Oh, I don't remember when she was in the tent. I think it was when she was laying there in her underwear.
Oh, yeah, just her. Yeah.
And they were like, oh, I'm supposed to be...
She was kind of hot. It was kind of. Not like I'd pursue it hot, mostly because it's illegal.
Come on, we both know you're going to try and kill Obama to impress her.
Yeah, I thought about it. So, yeah, as far as I'm concerned, Wes Anderson is 7 for 7. I've enjoyed all of his movies. I think
6 for 7.
Drew considers him 6 for 7, and
fuck Rushmore.
Hates one of what most people would consider Wes Anderson's best movies in Rushmore.
I hate it! Other than one funny line that is the best line in cinematic history.
Oh, these are O.R. scrubs.
Oh, are they?
The best.
But the rest of, I don't know, maybe if I give it another chance and try and watch it, I won't hate it.
Maybe watch it in a less hateful mood,
yeah,
and give it a second chance. Especially if they like everything else that he
got. Like, I love Life Aquatic. The movie is great.
Yeah, me too.
Great. Funny movie. It makes Willem Dafoe seem uglier.
Possible. Congratulations.
He may be the second ugliest man in Hollywood behind old caveman face Nick Caveman.
Old caveman face John C. Reilly, who, as we say, is doing a very good job of playing defense against his face and getting a lot of work. What else? Well, I didn't, but both of you guys saw Prometheus, so yeah. You will have to fill me in on that.
All I can say is, if you want to go, I'm still sort of up in the air of Prometheus, because I think the whole appeal to Prometheus was that, oh, it's a prequel to Alien, which really, it very, like, little has to do with Alien. I mean, it does tie into it, but not really all that much. It's kind of a separate movie in itself.
Yeah,
there's small references to this, you know, to Alien and stuff like that.
It's within the same Alien versus Predator.
It's not always Alien versus Predator.
Well, but, you know, like Alien and Predator. Yeah.
It's within that same umbrella of storyline and
universe.
Backstory. But, yeah, it wasn't really an Alien movie.
Although the appeal was to people
who knew that it was an Alien prequel.
So,
which is probably why it didn't do, like, you know, $200 million on the first week it was open.
Didn't do Avengers money?
on a movie on its own, it was fine. I didn't have any issues with it, but the reason I'm up in the air about it is because I've never in my life seen a movie that has brought me to that very edge of throwing up in the middle of the And, like, I've seen a lot of gory stuff in movies and stuff like that, but I never had my gut so twisted in my life, just this one scene.
It was cringeworthy.
And after that scene was done, like, and I was, like, physically cringe. I went and saw it by myself, and there was quite a few other people in the theater, but I was just sitting there kind of squirming in my seat physically, and like, okay, fine, that scene is over. But as the scene was over and the movie kept going, I found myself getting more and more dizzy. And I realized that I'm going to puke. So for 15 minutes, I physically struggled in my seat for 15 minutes trying not to puke. And all I could do was yawn. And that was like my defense mechanism to keep myself from puking. And
all right, yawn, me and you. We're in this together.
I was literally, for me, it was an on your head, from your seat experience, but for the wrong reason. So, that's kind of my take on it. If you got a strong stomach, go see it, but don't go into there thinking, oh, there's going to be so much to do with aliens.
I for once, was just glad that I was seeing a Michael Fassbender movie where it didn't happen to be his wiener.
I saw two movies in a row that had full-on, uncircumcised 9 inches of Fassbender just flapping around in the breeze, and this was the first time in a while that I hadn't had to see it.
Was it legit uncircumcised?
Oh, yeah. It was disgusting.
I'm impressed. You don't
win sunk.
Did you ever see that on camera?
He's European. They don't cut.
Good. All right. Good to know. I still got a chance of getting my dick on camera. Just have to grow 7 inches. What else we got? Do you guys hunger for games? No? Okay. Well, see you next week, guys.
We're not doing... Did you see anything in theaters? I saw things in theaters.
Didn't we just talk about something you saw?
That was you forcing me to talk about things.
Oh, you want to talk about your own thing. Okay.
I saw Brave. Reluctantly.
Okay. Yeah. Right. Yep. And it doesn't sound like what the trailer led me to believe. Or at least there's an element that I had no idea about.
Well, it's the same. It's the Disney, formulaic Disney movie where it's like, he doesn't want to be what parents make them to be, want to be something else, and then fantasy involved, and then parents getting scared and angry and emotions, and then animals acting silly and goofy.
It sounds like every movie I've ever seen.
I guess, but it's like, I mean, it was a Pixar movie. Like, you can't say anything bad about Pixar movies because they're incredibly wonderful and cheerful.
I'm going to think of something bad to say about Pixar movies. Oh, yeah, Cars is worthless. How about that?
You mean Cars?
Cars 2 is worthless.
Cars 2 is worthless. Cars 1.
I don't need either of those in my life.
And it's Paul Newman in it.
Yeah.
That's the last movie he ever did.
Fucking Larry the Cable Guy. Fuck it.
Maybe being in that movie with Larry the Cable Guy
killed Paul Newman.
It was his last dying breath. Why did I do that movie with Larry the Cable Guy?
Oh, speaking of last movies, you showed me a fantastic last movie today. The last thing Milton Berle ever did was a made-for-TV movie with Keenan and Kel.
What a way to go out.
Milton.
Little did he know that Keenan Thompson would become the greatest comedic actor of a 15-minute segment of SNL.
The greatest comedic actor to come out of the show Keenan and Kel. The least bankrupt member of the cast. So good on you, Keenan Thompson, for that one sketch out of 17 you do that I enjoy. I normally hate you. I do have kind of a morbid fascination with What's Up With That.
What's Up With That is pretty good.
But I think that's mainly Jason Sudeikis and Sam saying.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah.
All right, get that out of your system. Kelly, you see anything that I'm not forcing you to talk about? Freeform here.
Probably.
We're playing by the seat of our pants, folks. This is episode 1 of 108, and then we're done. 108.
Well, buckle down.
Buckle down.
I saw it a long time ago, but...
Then don't talk. You can't talk about it.
Oh, I don't like that.
All right, fine. This time only, exclusive, folks. Exclusive. Kelly talking about a movie... He saw a while ago.
That's right. And I told you about it. Hesher?
MC Hesher?
No, just Hesher.
Okay. I hope someone at home laughs at that.
How long ago was that? That was probably back in April.
Okay.
I guess, yeah. That was a good movie.
Just Gordon Levitt.
Yeah. Tommy from Dark of the Sun, I like to call him.
Yeah, no, it was good.
It was good.
And Natalie Portman.
Yeah.
I've never heard of this movie.
It's good. It's about, Gordon plays like this, he plays like a headbanger dude.
I don't think he appreciates you referring to him by one
name. No, that's what I'm talking
about. His name isn't Gordon.
I am calling him by his middle name. So, yeah, there you go. So, Drew is flashing the Blu-ray version of it.
Yes, Drew has it. Hey, folks, here's a fun game at home. Name a movie, and we'll tell you where on Drew's shelf it is, because he has it.
No, it's a good movie.
I have Ride Wars. Don't break
a lot of good lines. A lot of good lines, especially involving your grandma.
That's a pretty good scene.
So, there's a movie you go see if you're bored or sitting around.
All right, go see Hesher. Spelled how? Like it sounds?
Hesher.
Hesher.
Yeah, just like it sounds.
H-E-S-H-E-R?
Yeah.
All right.
But with the Metallica thing at the end.
Yeah, it looks like the Metallica logo because you got to rip them off because you get as much money out of them as you can.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Like, just like Davey Richards.
Go to the DVD store that doesn't exist anymore.
Yeah.
And look for the box with the Metallica-looking logo on it. But don't accidentally get Spinal Tap, because then you'll watch another good movie.
How dare you go for the wrong good movie.
Yeah. All right, any other... What are you pointing at?
How can we have Spinal Tap?
Yeah, we know you have, you know, every time, okay, if you're going to
point, game is happening.
If you're going to point to it every time we name a movie, we're never getting out of here.
What?
Stop naming a movie.
Sure. I haven't watched that movie yet with Nicole Kidman and,
Nicolas Cage. Oh, man.
Not a trespass.
Okay,
we'll get around to it.
We won't get that deep into Trespass, but here's what we know. It's two A-list actors, Nicolas Cage and Nicole Kidman. The budget was $35 million. Budget was $35 million. We haven't seen it, but presumably almost, like, 34 of that went to paying Nicolas Cage and Nicole Kidman, because I think the whole thing is filmed inside one house.
Yeah.
And it made, in the theaters, I think it's made a little more on DVD, I don't want to totally undersell it, but in theaters it made 25, $1,000. They made back almost 1/1,000th of their budget.
They made back the budget for the one scene where Nicolas Cage is sitting in the kitchen eating a sandwich. That's not the money it cost to pay him to do that.
They
one
made
scene,
back they the sandwich. Made back.
Everything else is kind of still in the red. But yeah, I'm sure we'll see that. And
probably a good sandwich.
It was probably a very good sandwich.
Sandwich for $25,000.
And if we're talking about bad movies, we watched a couple others. We watched The Room. We
watched three.
We did.
John and I watched the next one.
Drew and I watched the next one. We just watched House of 1,000 Corpses today for a reason beyond my comprehension.
We watched it because Chris Hardwick was in it.
Yeah, it does have some enjoyable feel. It's got Chris Hardwick in it. It's got Rainn Wilson in it.
Both kind of, well, okay, like I said, Rainn Wilson pre-fame, Chris Hardwick still when nobody cares.
Chris Hardwick still in none. Pretty much the same, although he has a podcast now, so he's moving on. We have a podcast. We have achieved Chris Hardwick levels of fame.
Yeah!
Although he's been on the TV.
Yeah, but who hasn't been on TV?
He hosted an MTV dating show in the late 90s. Single out, motherfucker.
Good for him.
We didn't do that.
Climbing the mountain.
What were you doing? You were in short pants in the late 90s.
I'm in short pants.
In short pants now. So here we are. And, yeah, so we watched The Room with written, produced, directed, and starring Tommy Wiseau. A professional crazy person.
Well, yeah, Tommy Wiseau though has been getting a lot of roles now on YouTube. As I told you, where he has like his own like show where he gets abducted by aliens and they force him to play like video games. And he was playing Mortal Kombat, making just the dumbest comments and like sexist comments. Sometimes like a woman fighter would come on and stuff like that. But I guess at the end...
Oh, hi, Sonya.
Yeah. Look at your giant tits. You think that you intimidate me? Lesbian. Something like that. And then...
Tommy Wiseau is not Arnold Schwarzenegger.
No, he's not.
For those that don't... If they are...
He
can't fucking play... His last name is French.
Yeah.
But that's not a French accent.
No, and like...
So I don't know if it's like Swiss French, so there's like weird French, German, Italian mixed in there.
Yeah.
He claims he is born and raised in the United States, and that is a falsehood.
But like at the end of the show, they'll make him do like a famous video game line. I just remember the one he did was, do a barrel roll. I like that.
Yeah, so I don't know what the hell we can say about The Room. Go watch it, download it. It's somewhere on the internet. I don't think it has a proper DVD release.
No. He was here, though, like, or maybe he's coming here, they're showing it at the Rio, and he's doing, like, a...
Oh, shit.
Almost like a Benson Interruption thing, I think.
If that doesn't happen yet, we should go to that.
I definitely remember seeing, like, I don't know, a poster or something for it, but yeah. Here they were showing it there, and he was going to be there, and I guess... Shit over his own movie? I don't know.
No,
he's going to defend it.
Yeah, I don't think he hits on it. I think he takes it seriously. Oh, the one thing he said is because it's, when you watch it, it is clearly a drama that failed and is hilarious in its awfulness. And now, since he found out that it failed, I think he's calling it a dark comedy now. He's like, those stupid things were meant to be funny. They weren't, Tommy. But that's how he's playing it now. But, not the case. So watch that. And in the same vein, again, don't think there's a proper DVD release. Go find it on the internet. Birdemic. Yeah. Shock and Terror. That movie is bonkers, and you need to go out of your way to see it. Its production values is even worse than The Room, and...
Everything about it is worse than The Room.
Everything about it is baffling. Like, they identified all the good movie choices and then did the other... thing. The best thing, and
I don't live
there. Oh God! See, we could do an hour on. Drew hasn't seen it, so I don't want to go too long. Just me and Kelly saw it, but
Kelly and I.
Oh, this is how we're planning.
We're going podcast grammar, please.
Podcast grammar.
That's gonna happen a lot with me.
Kelly and I saw it. And yeah, it's hard to narrow down a favorite thing. If I had to pick one, it's that every single scene, and I don't mean every scene, like every time the camera cuts, every time it switches shots, it takes 10 seconds too long to do it.
The scene has ended right before the shot.
Yeah, everyone's done. Everyone has checked out except the cameraman, who I guess the director is standing beside him with a gun, saying, hold it, hold it.
And the unnecessary cut.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, we'll hear that later.
We may do an entire show on that once everyone's seen it, once we do a group watch of it. And then also, in the bad movie department, this one with A-list actors, Tiptoes. Starring Gary Oldman, Matthew McConaughey.
Oh, my God.
Kate Beckinsale. And Peter Dinklage.
Peter Dinklage.
Gary Oldman as Matthew McConaughey's twin brother, even though they're clearly 30 years apart in age. The other fun twist, in addition to them being poor ages to play twins, Matthew McConaughey plays a guy that looks like Matthew McConaughey. Gary Oldman plays a midget. And, like, not a lot of time was spent on the midgetizing. Like, he is straight up like Tim Conway as Dorf. He's a dude on his knees with his knees in shoes. And the one step up from Dorf from 25 years ago where they had just invented cameras, he has the knees in the shoes, and then the rest of his legs are CG'd out. But oh my God, it looks terrible. And you very, very rarely see the bottom half of Gary Oldman. There's all these, like, clever, and I'm using clever in strong quotation marks, like, Austin Powers, like, camera gags that aren't funny, basically. Just, like, he's walking behind a counter, and, like, he's behind a... I love it when he was behind the midget bar.
The bar
that's the right height for a midget. And my favorite is when he's on a couch, when actual Gary Oldman is clearly in the couch, and he's got straight up Kermit the Frog legs dangling from his midsection.
Every time he's on screen, I couldn't stop laughing. Just because all I could think of was A, Dorf.
Yeah, it's Dorf fishing. I was waiting for him to do a weird Swedish accent, and we're good to go.
And B, people tripping over the back of Gary Oldman's legs in the scene.
Oh, yeah. And how the fuck did Peter Dinklage feel a legitimate midget and good actor, any winning these days, walking around like he normally walks around beside Gary Oldman on his fucking knees? That's like Denzel Washington next to, like, Russell Crowe in blackface.
I want to see this.
I watch that movie.
Blackface Russell Crowe. Wait, Blackface Russell Crowe or Blackface Denzel Washington?
No, Blackface Denzel Washington. Blacker Denzel Washington and regular Russell Crowe.
Okay, yeah, I think that.
I would find would be very insulting to Russell Crowe,
yeah.
Who is, as we all know, is very anti-makeup. Anyway, I asked it earlier prematurely, as I am wont to do, but at this juncture, do you hunger for games?
Yay!
Before the audience comes in. Maybe I'll even edit it in, although I probably won't, because that involves editing. So, let us do a quick round of build a title, and I will briefly explain what that is. Kelly is shaking his head already, because he feels he is horrible at it.
Well, I don't know, I'm just going to say this right now. It's going to be incredibly easy in this room full of movies.
Everyone has an advantage.
Everyone
has the same advantage.
I guess, okay.
Although the better reader is going to do better.
Hey, I got my glasses on. I'm good to go.
I got your glasses on. I don't have my glasses on.
Yeah, I need glasses.
And Kelly can't see anything. He just realized. So, build the title is simple enough. You start with the title of a movie, and you go around and you add more movie titles onto the beginning or end of that movie. And you don't, for the adding, you don't have to use the whole word. You can use the last syllable or the last sound or anything like that. So I think it'll become clear as we do it. I don't want to spend a ton of time actually explaining it. We all know how to do it.
Yeah, yeah.
And you will learn by listening. Education and entertainment wrapped in one for you, the fine listeners. How long am I going to do that?
You are pretty good there, though.
All right, do you have a movie to start with? Okay. There's stuff we can work from that. The first movie is Dreamhouse, and I guess the person who's going to host the first round will not be involved, so just me and you?
Yeah.
All right, so this is going to be me versus Drew to see who goes first in the next game. Yes, layers upon layers of games. Peel the game onion.
I just like to point out that Dreamhouse is fucking horrible. But that's for another day and time.
So we're going to start with Dreamhouse, one of the first movies that Drew whipped off the shelf. So I will turn your fucking phone off, you unprofessional.
That's all I got. No, oh,
I'm finished.
Are we finished?
So mad I cut myself off because I didn't want to regret what I was going to say.
Regret?
I didn't want to regret what I was going to say. Anyway, we'll start with Dreamhouse.
That's fucking cute.
Thank you, retard from Moonrise Kingdom. Okay, so we'll start with Dreamhouse. I'll add Dreamhouse on Haunted Hill.
I will go with Requiem for a Dreamhouse on Haunted Hill.
Ah, so now something that ends in Requiem, or it can end in Wreck. And what's on the other one? Hill? I'm going to keep the horror movie train going and go Requiem for a Dream House on Haunted Hills Have Eyes. We cut out the thes and as, because otherwise it doesn't work.
Well, I will go Requiem for a Dream House on Haunted Hills Have Eyes Wide Shut.
Well, I will see your Requiem for a Dream House on Haunted Hills Have Eyes Wide Shut and raise you a Requiem for a Dream House on Haunted Hills Have Eyes Wide Shutter Island.
There's no way I'd be able to do that.
Kelly is so glad he's not playing right now.
I will go with Requiem for a Dream House on Haunted Hills Have Eyes Wide Shut Island of Dr. Moreau.
You bastard! How dare you use my favorite movie against me?
Hey, it's a good goddamn movie.
I'm mad at you for using it. I wasn't being sarcastic. It's the best movie ever made. And
Marlon Brando,
the 90s one, not that bullshit black and white one that actually had a story.
Hey, you cannot speak ill of this one because it has Ron Perlman in his correct form.
A goat.
All the little kitty people.
I hope that came off as well on audio. Because not only was Kelly doing a pretty good audio of Marlon Brando impression, he had the face going through.
And the sweat coming
out. Yeah. The sweat away. You know how forced they sweat.
I can force a lot of things with sweat anymore.
Okay, so now I gotta end in Requiem or part of it, or start with Moreau or part of it.
Oh, Moreau.
Requiem for a Dream House on Haunted Hills Have Eyes Wide Shutter Island of Dr. Moreau, Brother, Where Art Thou?
Oh.
So there.
That's all I've ever moved.
Better than Island of Dr. Moreau? Really?
I didn't say that.
Okay, let's make it crazy. That was good.
All those people in depression.
And Brando's back. And the game is to you.
Am I allowed to look around?
You're not allowed to look around, you asshole!
It's everywhere! How do you not? Teaser behind me.
Good. Do I have to do an audio fill while you're thinking? Because people get bored. They got the short attention span.
Surprisingly, I thought of one.
I want to play the Graham Elwood style of game. Oh, where you just think of like a phrase that could be a movie.
Shipwreck is a movie, right? But Shipwreck is. Alvin and the Chipmunks. Shipwreck.
That's wrecked.
Wrecked.
Not, it's not Requiem for a Dream. So, no,
Graham Elwood style does not work for me.
No. I do like the make up something that sounds like a movie and see if it'll play. But not on my watch.
I could help you out, but that'd probably be cheating.
No help, please. You can say it after he says it.
Okay.
Unless it's on the other part of the word, then you gotta wait.
Thousand Island Dressing is a
All right, so I win. Kelly, what was your ad?
I think you could. Would you be able to go out of a dream house on Haunted Hill? Do they have eyes? Why? I don't know if Dr. Moreau, brother, were art school confidential.
No, he's got his
Yeah.
Okay.
So no, Kelly did not have it.
Nope.
Kelly remains batting zero.
Still afraid of this.
That means I go first in the main event, the first of three main events that are the same, hosted by each of the three of us.
Kelly's presenting.
Kelly is presenting for some reason. That's why this is an audio and not a video podcast.
My defense. I'm going to grab food sit for a second.
Okay.
Not food.
Okay. Drew's quickly running to pee while I briefly explain the Leonard Moulton game, which is our main event. So each of the three of us is going to host a round of it. Well, I guess we'll play the three or something.
Yeah.
Kind of guessing at what'll be the right amount of time before you completely lose interest.
I'm having a pretty great stretch.
Kelly's getting stretched up to host this. I appreciate a limber host. So the Leonard Moulton game is essentially Name That Tune, but with actors and movies instead of notes and songs. So what Kelly's going to do is he's going to give me a couple of categories to choose from. I will choose one. He may or may not give me the year of a movie to choose from. Then he's going to tell me how many actors are listed in the official Leonard Moulton Movie Guide app on my information pad, iPad, if you will. And he's going to tell me the year it was made. He's going to tell me Leonard's star rating, which is a scale of bomb to four. Bomb being bad, not the bomb, as I believe.
Bomb.
The bomb, as I believe the kids just started saying. and tell me how many actors are listed. I then bid how many actors, read from the bottom up, so very rarely we're going to hear the actual stars, read from the bottom up, I can guess what movie it is in. And then it goes to Drew, and he has to either underbid me or say name that movie. And the bidding goes then to whatever. If it ends at six, it ends at six. It can go to zero if you're sure you know it just from the brief description. You can bid zero. Bidding actually doesn't necessarily have to stop at zero. It can go into negatives, where if Drew bids, say, negative one, he has to name the movie and the top billed person. If it's negative two, he's got to name the movie and the top two billed people in order on the Leonard Moulton app. And Leonard sometimes gets a little creative with his billing. Sometimes, even though the person has less screen time, they're the most famous and they get billed first, so it's up to Leonard's discretion sometimes.
There was the whole Rossi debacle.
There was the Deroccle.
Deroccle. Yes, Deroccle.
Where, the cast list on Rocky was a...
Burgess Meredith was like...
Second.
Yeah, second, and Carl Weathers was fifth?
Something like that. Even though the screen time was like opposite for those
two. Yeah, I don't know.
Anyway, baffling. So, there's your game. Let's do it. Me versus Drew. Figure play to three?
Sure.
See how it goes. If it goes really quick, we'll make a...
I think Kelly has enough.
Call an audible and play to more than three.
Yeah.
But, yeah, we got three rounds to do, so we'll blaze through and see how it goes. So, I guess Kelly's going. I'm going to toss it over to Kelly, and he will have me pick a category.
All right. Here's your categories. We got Hurt Me Baby One More Time, which are the films of John and William Hurt.
John and William.
They don't necessarily have to star in it.
Oh, but they have to be in it.
But they have to be in it. But they don't both star in it.
Only one of them.
Yeah. A Hurt is in it.
A Hurt is in it.
Okay. Workers Gotta Work.
Workers Gotta Work.
Films that involve professional wrestlers.
Love it.
And All the Small Things movies that involve midgets.
I wonder if you would actually do
I could go negative three on that.
Midgets, wrestlers, or the Hurts. Let's go Workers Gotta Work. Let's go wrestlers.
If only there was one for midget wrestlers.
Well, we got some lighting issues with Hurts. I'm having a stroke.
Drew has turned the bedroom light into strobe, and is testing if we have epilepsy.
It hurts really soft.
Okay, so I'll give you the years you can choose from.
Okay.
You got 1993.
That's a long time ago.
2004.
Okay.
2009. Does it have to be sparring wrestlers, or they're just in it?
They're just in it.
All right. Let's go current. Let's go 2009.
All right.
So Kelly's going to look up the movie on the Leonard Moulton app. He's going to tell me, we know the year. He's going to tell me the star rating, the number of actors, and read me a couple blips from Leonard's review of it that don't give anything away, really.
Yeah. We have bartender in here.
Yeah, we should be getting drunk right now.
Actual beer. And I have butter ripple schnapps.
Beer and some butter ripple schnapps.
All right. That's been sitting here for like a week.
And some old root beer.
So,
yeah, we can make a party out of this.
All right. So we got 2 stars.
All right.
2 stars. And it has 7 actors.
Okay.
Okay. And let's see here.
Tell me about this movie. Preferably the name of it.
Annoying in the extreme and unintelligible at times, the film gets better in the second half as an actual story emerges. That's really all I can tell you without giving you away.
Okay.
Sorry, what year did we do? Yeah. 9?
Oh, 9. And 7 actors. I'm not going to talk about it. I'm not going to show my hand. I'm going to say 5. So Drew can now say 4 or less, or tell me the name of that movie.
I'm going to say...
First of all, you're going to talk louder.
Realistically, we should know these.
You think.
Because the only wrestlers that we know that are in movies are the big name wrestlers.
Yeah.
So I will say 4.
Okay. Fuck it, 3.
My concern with 3...
Is that you might not hear the wrestler?
Is that the wrestler might be lower on the...
Because there might be, like,
bigger named actors above.
And then the wrestler's hanging out. It could be Kevin Nash and Grandma's Boy.
Absolutely. I don't know that he would get a billing in that.
He should. He was fantastic.
I agree. You know what? I'm going to say something in that movie.
I'm going to say, fuck you, Juice Man.
3. From the bottom.
From the bottom up.
So, James Fox.
Is that Jamie Fox?
No, James Fox.
Who the fuck is James Fox?
James Fox, Kelly Riley, and Eddie Marson.
Well... In the category of things that didn't help.
Do you know who Eddie Marson is?
No. You want to tell me?
No, yeah. I don't know who he is.
I would tell you.
Yeah, he wouldn't.
Was he one of the Munsters, or was that Eddie Munster?
Or Eddie Munster.
Hmm.
He was a wolf.
He was a wolf. Okay. 2009 has wrestler or wrestlers in it. What was your description bit again? Something about
annoying in the extreme and unintelligible at times, the film gets better in the second half as an actual story emerges.
2009. You know, I don't think it's right. I'm going to say The Marine.
No.
Fuck.
Is it The Damage?
I don't think that was
no. Definitely not
The
it.
Damage.
Suck it.
Damage, not the
or
damage.
Damage, whatever. What is not damage or the damage?
Keep reading the cast up and we'll see if we have any more.
Mark Strong, Rachel McAdams, Jude Law, Robert Downey.
Oh my God! It was Robert Mallet. Friggin'
Kurgan.
Fuck
me. Fucking hell. Good one, Cal. Good one.
That's bullshit. I'm
fine. He has a good fight team with Robert Downey Jr. in that movie. He's French. And he'll speak French, yeah.
I'm filing a protest on that one.
Okay.
Fuck that. I didn't even recognize the wrestler's name.
Are you filing a protest because he's not a good wrestler, or because that shouldn't count because he's not really...
I think you guys should keep going with the worst.
Well, I told Scott to name it, so I go to Scott again.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's 1 point for Drew, for those keeping score. Give me some categories.
Oh, those are the only three I have right now.
Oh, okay. So,
yeah.
Well, that one didn't serve me well, so I'm going, what, all the small things?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do that.
Okay. So here are the years for you. 1996.
Mm-hmm.
2003.
Mm-hmm.
Memories of Me.
Oh, nope, that was a movie. Funny. Well
done,
played.
Done.
Don't worry about that one, man.
And I didn't even know what that movie
is. But there's more than all that. So, I mean, that's just really good. I'm going to get rid of it. But,
you have to cover your ass.
I've never heard of that movie.
I've never heard of it. Yeah. It was made in 1988.
Ugh.
Who's in it? Peter Dinklage?
Nope.
Phil Fondacara.
Fondacara?
Or Fondacaro?
No.
He played the little guy in all those classic horror movies.
Was he in Ewok?
No.
He might have been. I don't know.
Anyway, and the last one was, 96, 2003, and 2009.
2003. Midgets in 2003. See, here's a problem. I already have one in my head, So now I'm going to be, like, biased towards it.
I'll be honest with you. I was going to go with Tiptoes, but there's no review for it, so.
I'm actually not surprised.
Yeah, me either.
Okay, so 3 stars. Okay.
3 stars.
Still fits in what I'm thinking.
8 actors.
That doesn't fit in what I'm thinking. Mine had a lot of actors in it.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck. Well, back to the drawing board. What do we got?
Okay. A small, observant, immediately satisfying film. Writer and first-time director McCarthy tailored the leading roles for these 3 actors.
Oh, boy.
Let's see if there's anything else I can get.
Can you give me some volume?
I can tell you that...
Put some bass in that voice.
I can give you part of, like, the plot, but it doesn't really... I mean, that'll be able to help you much. But
do what you feel is right.
Professionally original indie about 3 lonely people who become friends in a quiet lakefront New Jersey town.
Okay.
Definitely not what I'm thinking of.
Nope. Definitely not Lord of the Rings, Return of the King.
I was going to say Elf. Elf I did consider.
Yeah, so that's out. and how many?
8.
8. I'm going to say 8. Bold opening bid, I know.
I will say 7.
I don't think either of us know this movie, so I'm going to say Drew named that movie.
What is the stance on racism on this podcast? Because I might be forced to yell some things.
Encouraged.
Okay. So I believe I'm going to the 7, or I believe Josh Pice. Josh Pice, Richard Kind, Michelle Williams, Paul Benjamin, Raven Goodwin, Bobby Cannavale, and Patricia Clarkson. And you, if you got the first, if you had the 8 or whatever, you would have definitely. You definitely would know who the actor was.
I know most of those names. Like, I know who the actors are.
Yeah. It's not Jackass, right? It's not Wee Man?
No, it's not Wee Man.
I don't think what I described.
Well, maybe that's the Jackass 2.25.
I love that as the description of Jackass. So, yeah.
Like an indie movie where 3 friends come together. That's such an adorable description, I guess.
I honestly, like, no idea. Like, I know some movies of action, but none of them have midgets.
Yeah,
I think I have to call, like,
I made the right call.
I'm going with Elf.
<It's not laughs> Who's the last actor?
Peter Dinklage.
Fuck. I don't think I know this movie.
The movie?
Tiptoes.
I wanted it to be movie is The Station Agent, which is where Peter Dinklage inherits a...
I have real
and you know what? They actually have that on Goblin Movie.
Oh. Yeah, that's come... Yeah.
Oh.
I've never seen it, though.
No, I haven't either.
I want to see it, though. One apiece, and it's on Drew Picks.
And flips me off while doing it.
I will go with the movies of John and William Hurt.
Okay, let me just crack these up.
As I love both of them.
Pick one.
I think I like William Hurt more because I know more of his movies, but John Hurt's really good in Alien.
Okay. Let's see here. We got 2004, 1998, and 1997.
I'll pick 2004. 2004, and it's got a Hurt. I'm going to guess William.
I'm going to hurt you.
Hmm. Strong words. Coming from a guy with a dick out.
<Saw that? laughs> You know what? When I went in the bathroom to take a pee, when I take a poop, I definitely get Kelly.
Tell me you did
pee.
Not do.
You didn't take your shirt off, did you?
No. Dick through the short leg?
Why?
Okay.
I didn't from this game. Because... This is a Pete Holmes sidebar.
Sidebar.
Here's the thing. Because every time I do a fucking movie, there's some asshole there that has to ruin it for me. Right? We went to Thor, there's the guy who stunk. He's just a stinkhead that sat beside me and laughed at, much like the other guy was doing, except this guy wasn't, he wasn't, like, mentally challenged. He was just a shithead.
And I think he was drunk.
Yeah.
But yeah, Thor was definitely the funniest movie that guy had ever seen.
We had the dude dealing with the dude at Moonrise Kingdom. Then when, like, back in 2009, we saw that stupid Adventureland movie. Every time fucking someone kissed in that movie, these assholes behind me would go, "Aw, yeah!" Every time! Like, they hadn't seen it before.
Hey, kissing is exciting.
People making out with a new experience to them.
Yeah.
So, anyways... So after dealing with that at Moonrise Kingdom, I have to go to the bathroom. I go in the bathroom. There is the urinals. I go and use one. And as I turn to leave, there's a dude at the urinal, just like down, a couple of urinals down, peeing. But he has his dick through the side of his shorts, like of the short sleeve. He's like, peeing away.
This guy knows what's up.
Unacceptable. Okay, where was I? All right. 2004.
Sidebar over.
1.5 stars.
Oh, come on. It hurts. Make better movies.
Double check. 15.
Oof.
Okay. Let's see what we got for 15 actors. Okay. I can really give you evolve into a self-parody at some point before becoming downright ridiculous.
And it's me, right?
Yeah. And it's you.
Okay.
Out of 15.
I am going to say that I can name this movie in 0 names.
Fuck to you.
If it's the movie that, if you know this movie.
Okay. No,
don't okay. Give it a hint. We'll play the goddamn game.
Drew bid 0. So, for those paying attention, I have to... In order to continue, I have to bid -1, which means I have to name the movie and the star, which is going to be very difficult, because I might guess the star is William Hurt, but I don't know the name of the movie! So I can't really go too much further with this, so I regrettably have to say, Drew, name that movie.
Can I change my vote to -1? No.
Fuck off!
Is this film The Village?
You are correct.
Got it!
Yeah. William Hurt! Would #1 have been Walking Phoenix?
Yeah.
And #2 would have been, oh, God, Bryce Dallas Howard?
No, she's number 4. No, she's #5. Adrian Brody was #3.
Oh, okay, I get that.
It went Joaquin Phoenix, Adrian Brody, William Hurt, Sigourney Weaver, Brycey, Brendan Gleeson, Cherry Jones, John Elliman.
Okay. Wait,
Jesse Eisenberg was it.
I forgot.
I think I remember that.
He was one of the kids on the stump.
Yeah.
Jesse Eisenberg.
No, he was the kid. Yeah, he was the kid that was playing the Back to the Woods game.
Yeah. It was a scary game.
Big nose.
Curly hair.
Curly hair. Fucking Jew.
Hey.
Well, it's encouraged.
Yeah. All right.
Well, that would have gone well if we had both known the name of the movie and -2 had come to you. Then I would have won. That's a lot of factors that weren't the case. But,
definitely would not have guessed Adrian Brody as #2.
Here we are. So, 2-1 for Drew, and Drew picks.
You told me to name it, so yes, I pick. I will go with Workers.
1993 or 2004?
Oh, interesting.
There was definitely one that I wanted to put in there, but I couldn't because it was on there.
I don't think you guys ever would have got it.
I don't think I would have.
Was it the wrestler with that answer?
No. I should have put that in them.
I'll go to 2004.
You seem really unsure about that.
Well,
93 is such a fun year.
93, I'm trying to think of what it is, and then, oh, God, I think I might know what it is.
I'm pretty sure I know who the wrestler is in 93, but...
I hope it's what I hope it is.
Could be one of a couple movies.
If you get this wrong, if you win this round, you're picking that category.
If I win this round, I'll pick the last wrestling one.
You know what? Even if whoever wins should, just as a bonus, should be the last.
Okay.
The 2004, it's got a wrestler in it.
Okay. Don't look!
So it had 2.5 stars.
Not what I was thinking it was. I was thinking bomb.
04, decent movie. Excellent casting and some good laughs mitigated by films over-reliance on ideas borrowed from risky business. Key scenes that don't ring true and a storyline that's much more complicated than it has to be. And there are...
I feel like a wrestler isn't the star.
Yeah, I'm going to say...
There are 8. 8 stars. It is to Drew.
I'm going to say 8.
7.
I will say 6.
Now we're into riskier territory. So if I say 5, I got 5 out of 8. Can I do it with 5 out of 8?
6 out of 8 doesn't give me...
6 gives a good chunk. I'll go 5.
Here's my problem. I haven't seen Risky Business, so I have nothing to compare it to.
Tom Cruise flipping around in
the... That's all I know. I only know that scene.
I don't think it really has anything.
Oh, okay. Well, I will say it's going to name the movie.
Oof. Okay.
I don't think I can
do 5. 5 of 8. That's okay. I can do it.
For the bottom up, it's a 5. Jacob Young. Timothy Bottoms.
I know him.
Paul Dano.
I know that name. I got to place the face.
Chris Marquette. You say 5?
Yeah.
And James Remar.
Dexter's dad. What are you doing, Dexter's dad? Huh, it's the wrong year
to be for Dexter's dad.
The wrong year for the quest.
Is there a wrestler?
That was a little, there must have been. There was all kinds of timing.
Yeah, there had to be a wrestler in the quest.
Guys, like a goddamn monkey. But as for James Remar in a thing just before Dexter started, I didn't think he worked behind the question. 2.5 stars, 04, wrestlers in it. I'm not enjoying this.
Fuck.
I don't want to take up too much time because nobody enjoys Dead Air. I may have to, unfortunately... I gotta throw something out there. Who's a wrestler? Chris Jericho was a wrestler. What was he? What did Hulk Hogan do in 2004?
I'm gonna go too.
Nothing. When was that fucking Three Ninjas movie? No, I got nothing. Drew wins it. Give me more names. More names.
Keep going up.
Have you read the wrestler's name yet?
No. Give me Oliphant.
Oliphant.
Oliphant, man. Elephant. Now I should
Oh,
Emil Hirsch.
Yeah.
I know what it is. Go next door, and the wrestler is...
Oh, Luger Reigns! Shit. I would have got it at Alicia Cuthbert. Was she first or second?
She was second.
So I would have needed 7.
Now, I think you should do the last...
The last wrestler one?
Yeah.
Sure. For funsies.
For funsies. Okay, hold on. I want to make a guess, but I'll let Kelly read the thing. Yeah.
Now, before you read it, can I say, is this one of your all-time favorite movies from when you were a kid?
I did love it when I was a kid.
Okay, then I think I know what it is.
No, I think it's the 80s. I'm just thinking of a bunch of Hulk Hogan movies.
It's not Hulk Hogan.
So,
Piper?
All right.
That's 2. 2 stars.
Okay.
2 stars is kind of what, like a C-plus? Average?
Yeah.
Like an average movie?
16 yeah. names.
A lot of people.
Generally bad writing and an overall air of unpleasantness torpedo this film. Good action scenes and occasional clever ideas can't save it. A raft of cameo appearances add to the in-joke tone of the picture. Definitely not what I was thinking it was then.
Huh. Yes.
Yeah.
16.
15.
14.
13.
12.
10.
Name it. So.
10 names from the bottom up.
Alright.
So, 93.
93.
With the stars.
A restaurant. Yeah, the bottom 10.
So it's a little bit action-y, obviously.
Okay. Michael V. Gazzo.
No help.
Rick Ducamon?
No help.
Tina Turner?
Okay.
Joan Plowright?
That Joan Plowright.
Professor Toru Tanaka? No clue. Ian McKellen?
Oh. What?
Austin O'Brien? Mercedes Rule?
I don't know if that's like, not the last one.
Anthony Quinn? Robert Persky? And Tom Noonan?
I knew one of those names, and it was Ian McKellen, and he was towards the bottom.
I knew a few, but I know when I'm getting this movie. No, I would
have
got this
movie. I'm just going to have to guess an Ian McKellen movie, aren't I? What's that one where he gets AIDS?
Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings.
Oh, God. Ian McComish from 93.
It won't help you, but the worker is Professor Toro Tanaka.
I don't know who that is. Like a 70s guy team did some stuff with Mr. Fuji. Yeah. So.
You asshole thought it was Hogan.
I thought it was Major Payne.
I thought it was
Damn,
that's a good one. I'm surprised
it Gremlins 2 or Santa with Muscle.
Suburban Commando?
Yeah. I honestly have no idea.
Let me go with
more. Keep going. Go up and go more.
Frank McCray, Charles Dance, Art Carney, F. Murray Abraham.
Up to winning.
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Red Heat? Is that a movie?
Red Heat is a movie, but that's not the movie.
I'll give you another hint. Danny DeVito is in it as a cartoon cat.
What?
Last Action Hero.
Yes.
So it wasn't the actor was my favorite movies. I'm like, I liked it growing up. I have it. So there.
Again, we know
you have it. I could stop naming movies and I'll stop pointing
Fine,
at
we'll
them.
Stop talking about movies on ISUXDIX Loves Movies or Heart Cinema.
I thought those were pretty good.
Those were good. I think we should just do pause.
All right, I think we're back. I think that worked. Okay.
Oh, my God.
Relocation.
Yeah, if the acoustics are any different, it's because we moved rooms. So we'll see which is better. And then next time we'll do the one that was worse.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Drew won that last one, but I won the moral victory because I got the game we did for fun afterwards. Yeah. So now Drew's going to host one. Of me versus
I still think we should do both titles. That didn't take us very long.
You want to do both titles?
I think we should both do both titles. That didn't take us very long. It's like 10-15.
Good.
Yeah, go at it.
No, you're in.
No, it's going to be you and Scott. Tell you to try it. Even if you don't do it well, it's only going to last like 2 minutes.
That's true. If you don't do it well, it's
going
to quickly.
I can't help you. You're just going to think of movies that match up.
All right. So I guess, okay, so we will do both titles to determine who goes first.
The movie we'll start with will be...
This is good radio.
Well, I'm sorry when you're trying to think.
I know.
Let's go with... Can we use the same one that we've used like 3 times?
Sure.
Men in Black.
Yeah, this, I don't know. It leaves you a lot of stuff, so it's good that way.
With Men in Black, so it has to end with men or start with black.
Yeah.
I guess your challenger, so you can go first.
Go for it.
Men in Black Snake Moan.
Oh, good, because there's so much stuff that starts with moan. Or own. Something must start with own. But regardless.
Get up.
Matchstick Men in Black Snake Moan. Yeah, good apples.
What is that apple juice? I like that a lot better than that.
Oh,
my shit.
I'm trying to think of something that I
want. I can think of her song title.
Oh, yeah.
I can try. I don't know if it'll work, but Matchstick Men in Black Snake Mona Lisa Smile?
Yes.
That works.
Stupid thing that I shouldn't do. I can do it, but
Matchstick Men in Black Snake Mona Lisa Smile and Dr. Moreau.
Alright, I'll do it. What the fuck? It's funny. I'll do it.
And I'm redeemed because I got to use it this time and not my opponent using the best movie ever made against me.
So it has to end with matchstick or match.
Yeah, it'll probably end with match or
and start with Moro or
Moro or
Moro.
Yeah.
Row.
Is Row your boat a movie?
That's my grandpa's impression. Drew can decide time limits.
Now,
Now, so it can end in, I can start with something with Row.
Yes.
Row or end with Match. Would, I don't know if, I'll take a guess, I don't know if it would work, but Matchstick, Man in Black, Snake Moon, Lisa, Lonely Mises.
Smile
instead of Doctor.
Yeah, something stupid, and I like it.
Oh, it's got a giggle. Rwanda Hotel?
More Rwanda? No.
No.
Also, the movie is called Hotel Rwanda.
That's right.
So even Morocco Rwanda would be better, and still wrong.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it to him.
You're an actor.
Kevin.
Yeah. I could not think of anything with Matt.
Dead State.
I did pretty good.
Yeah, pretty good. You did. I don't think you embarrassed yourself, which is why you made it sound like you were going to do. All right.
So I'm going to start off with some of my newer ones, and then we'll get into some old ones.
Some classics.
So, Scott Anson, your choices are, today is Frances McDormand's birthday.
Okay.
So there will be some Frances McDormand.
I enjoy her work. I saw her last week.
You did see her last week.
In the theater. I didn't actually, hang out with her.
Well, yeah. You didn't have to tell them that. They could have assumed, and then you would say, of course.
I don't know. I'm full disclosure over
here.
Okay. Well, Scott's hanging out with Frances McDormand. She's as cool as I thought he was.
You could have, similar to Kelly's category, which is short films. Movie starring a midget or a little person.
More movies, goddamn
midget. In the line of fire, which is movies involving firemen who die in a fire.
I like all of those. Let's go with my best friend, Frances McDormand.
Would you like one from 2000?
Nope.
2008?
Yes.
1996.
I would like 2008. And before you say a word, I would like to say I will name it in zero names.
Okay.
Your move, Summer.
2.5 stars. It has 10 actors. And it's, mixing ingredients with political thriller with a satiric jibes at Americans' obsession with self-improvement. It's never quite gels, though. It's fun to watch, and these talented stars playing morons. And the act one.
Pick it with zero.
Kelly, 2.5.
What do you got for me?
2008.
Negative one or GTFO?
Frances McDormand is one of the people in the movie. You know who she is?
Never.
She is the mom.
I know who she is. Oh, okay. I don't think if I've seen her in other places, I don't remember.
It's our Moonrise Kingdom last week.
Yeah. But I know fucking clue.
Cool it's our Moonrise Kingdom, because that's 2012.
I'm going to get the fuck out of here.
Burn after reading.
And a lot easier than I thought it would be. That was what it was.
I was thinking about negatives, but there's a lot of people they could go.
Who would you have gone negative?
I'd have gone Clooney first.
Yes.
Would they go Pitt second?
Nope.
McDormand second?
Yep.
Then Pitt?
Yep.
He should lose that.
After answering correctly and talking more about it, yeah. I should lose. Fourth. J.K. Simmons would be lower.
Put John Lamar, come on.
It's
an SNL skit with Burns and Italian guy who likes to pronounce John Malkovich's name like that.
Yeah, Malkovich. Where's Jake Gibson? It's probably...
He's ninth.
Yeah.
He's the other one. Swinton is the other figure.
Caleb and then Swinton.
Richard Jenkins, who is awesome.
Who is the man.
Always. Who is always. Okay, so...
One for Scott.
One for Scott.
And that means that
Kelly told me to name it, so I'm...
Oh, yeah, did. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to go recently. I don't know how recently. IMDb did a modern top 250 movies.
Okay.
So those movies from 1970 till now.
Okay. So the oldest is 1970.
No, the oldest would be 1970.
Okay.
And then let's see. Let's go Academy Award winners for Best Actor, 1990 to 2000.
Okay.
And we will say Major League Baseball movies. Hmm. Yeah, so that is a movie that features a Major League Baseball team.
I like all of those to a degree. Let's go Best Actor, 90s.
Would you like 1997, 1990, or 1994?
Hmm.
7-4-0.
Zero. Which may be my downfall. I'm trying to remember why I just picked that.
I don't know. Okay. Leonard Maltin gives it 3.5 stars.
Okay.
It has 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 actors.
Alright.
Let's see. It's an intensely moving story with just the right touch of humor and warmth.
Okay.
What year? 1990. Both the main actor and actress won for best performances as a lead.
Huh.
Not just the male, but also the female. And I said 1990, 3.5 stars. Now I will say, it won the Academy Award in 1990, but that means that it was from 1989.
Right. Yeah, so it won at the 1990 Awards in, like, February, March 1990,
so
right?
Technically 1989.
Okay. Hmm. I'm honestly debating between 9 and negative 1. In the interest of gameplay, let's go 9. Seven. Six. Five.
Yeah.
5 out of 9. All right, which, can I pick which five? I really like the star.
Yeah.
It would help.
Okay, so your five names are Allison Whelan, Ruth McCain, Adrian Dunbar, Cyril Cusack. I don't know if there's
what
any...
What the hell is that? Who's that? Is that?
I don't know. And Fiona Shaw.
Those were so much no help. I'm going to go with what I thought when I was thinking negative one. My left foot.
You should have gone negative one off the bat.
Santa Day Lewis, my left foot.
Nice! Have you ever seen my left foot?
No.
Do you know what it is?
No. Have you seen Stewie Griffin?
I've never seen it, but I've heard nothing but silly things about it. Okay, so that's,
for the record, I'm very pleased with myself.
2 points for Scott getting his run through.
And that's it again.
Yeah. So, would you like short film?
Idiot.
Three-letter movies. So, movies that have three letters in the title.
Was Alf a movie?
It was not Alf, it was Operation Alf.
Then I'm out.
Three-letter movie. Let's go the IMDb Modern Top 250 film.
Let's go three-letter.
I'm not giving you an option because I only have two.
Okay.
The movie is from 2001. 2.5 stars. It has 17 names.
Holy shit.
Let's see. Despite its length, the film is surprisingly sketchy. You know what? The only other thing I can say is director's cut runs 165 minutes.
It's pretty long.
That's 2 hours and 25 minutes. No, 2 hours and 45.
45. That's a lot of movies.
My math is poor.
Well, you tried your best. Huh. Number of actors? Oh, a million.
17.
Ugh, that's a mess. Well, let's open the bid 14.
13.
12.
11.
out of 17? Huh. Kelly hasn't got to name anything yet, so let's change that. Name it.
With 11.
Don't tell me what to do. That's for the nature of the game.
No, it's not.
Okay. Kelly's both had issues with the story.
So 11 names on this 2001 film with 2.5 stars.
Sky. Ice.
Is.
Cat.
LeVar Burton.
Good start.
Lawrence Mason. Giancarlo Esposito. Barry Shabaka Henley, Bruce McGill, Paul Rodriguez, Joe Morton, Mikhail Michel.
That's a stupid name.
Nona Gay, Jada Pinkett Smith, and McKelty Williamson.
Good luck.
I'm gonna be a fast motherfucking game. I just saw a funny name in it, right? I forgot was in this movie.
Funnier than Mikhail Michelle? Or what was the other one? Winona Gay?
Nona.
No, oh, no, even better.
McKelty Williamson. He's black.
Yeah.
Because his name is McKelty.
Yep.
He is, if I'm not mistaken, he is...
the black guy in something?
He is... Bubba from Forrest Gump.
Oh, okay. I think it might be right, actually. Hmm. You know, it seems like three-letter movies should be easy, but luckily I'm not the one doing this. I don't know a fucking clue. So, balls in your court, Summers.
Well, that's not...
What the...
Take it easy.
What's our time? Like, I feel like I should be wrapping up the Jeopardy theme about now.
We'll give them a couple seconds here.
Okay, an hour talk.
Oh, yeah. That's why.
Yeah, 1 hour from now. Okay, everyone listen to Patchwork, 1 hour.
I have no idea. So. Okay, well,
give us more names.
I'm going to propose before I read the theme that we do a second game with you too. Maybe give some easier categories.
We've run a fair bit. But I want to keep people's interest for the first one. Don't flip me off when I'm talking.
Okay, fine. Well, I feel bad for Kelly that he kept saying.
We can play off camera.
Jeffrey Wright
off microphone.
Jeffrey Wright,
you the shit off microphone. They won't know. They won't know how good I was.
Yeah.
Like last time we played, I fucking blew through it. I will say, the last time we played this, the most recent time we have played before this taping, Kelly fucking smoked it. You're getting like semi-obscure something. You got blue streak out of nowhere.
Yeah, -1 on that. I got -2 on Kiss Kiss Bang Bang.
Yeah, -2 on Kiss Kiss Bang Bang, which is a tough one because that could go either way with the billing.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Anyway, you go ahead. So stay tuned to future episodes where Kelly doesn't get his ass kicked. Yeah.
So, Jeffrey Wright, Ron Silver, Mario Bambino, this is the name I'm laughing at. John Voight.
If it was four-letter movies, I'd be all over this.
Anaconda, but broken up into three sections.
Anaconda.
Jamie Foxx. And Will Smith.
Ali.
Ali.
I don't watch those colored films anyway. That was Kelly.
What?
Yeah, I'm bringing you down with me.
No. All right, so that ends our game.
That... leaves Scott Henson as your gracious host.
Okay.
And apparently. So, quick round, belt title between Kelly and Drew to determine who's going first in the Lightning Mountain game.
Probably me.
The movie we shall start with is going to be told to me by Leonard Maltin himself.
At his party.
And
it's going to smell real bad.
The Leonard movie we're going to deal with is The Lucky One.
So Lucky One.
Yeah, so yeah, so take out The and Lucky One. Going with The Lucky One because it's been described to me as the best movie by the guy who made that movie since The Notebook. I believe he has made one movie in between those.
Didn't I tell you to turn your fucking phone off?
You're a liar.
It's going to get stinky in here, by the way.
Great.
The Lucky One. Me and Cal.
You go for it. One flew over the cuckoo's nest.
Lucky one flew over the cuckoo's nest.
That works. That doesn't work. That's not baseball cuckoo's nest, but I'm gonna
spread it anyway.
I definitely forget the big cuckoo's nest. That's not your finest work. For those who can't see what Drew's written down, he has started the word cuckoo with C-O-U, which is just a bad start, and it doesn't get any better from there. He came way closer to spelling couscous. Way closer.
There you go, cockroach.
Yeah. This is going badly. Drew, I feel like Drew dropped out of school in grade six. Or sixth grade for you assholes in the U.S. listening to this. Anyway. Lucky
I
one
can't
flew
think
over
of
the
movies
nest.
That have nest in
there. Nest or est.
Or lucky.
There's lucky numbers, but
that's
is something that ends
11.
Something
I want to say get lucky, but I'm pretty sure I'm thinking of get shorty.
I think that's get shorty. Something that ends in lucky. It's something that ends in luck. There's going to be something that ends in luck.
No, what I was thinking of doesn't.
Press Your Luck, did they make a movie out of that game show?
I think so.
Was the Landy the bad guy? I'm sure they made a movie out
of that. There has to be a movie called Bad Luck.
I don't know, you can't look it up. You have to tell us something about
who
it.
Who did it?
My friend.
Kim. What's his name? Jason Schwartzman. And he can't swim very good, so.
I'm going to look up the name. You know what? I'm looking up Bad Luck, and if there, this game continues.
Okay.
No. Leonard says no. Hard Luck?
No.
No luck. No luck. Anything with goddamn luck in it, that's going to be all stuff that starts. Plenty of stuff that starts with the word luck or lucky, but not much that ends it, unfortunately.
Can't say. Good luck, Chuckworm. Watching with the cuckoo's nest. Damn it.
No, that's a shame.
I can't think of too many with nest.
No, Nest is a stopper.
Oh, I think it's Nestle XT.
The movie?
Look up if there's anything that says Nest.
Anything that starts with Nest.
Nestor Carbonell.
Smart Money, again, more of an actor than a movie.
More of a lost cast member than
Nest. The Nest, so that gives us something. The Nesting, which no one's ever heard of, and a second movie called The Nest.
Alright, well, this is going on.
So, that's a stopper from Drew.
Wow, we got two.
I was screwing around on that one. All right, Drew is up to you. Let's get some newish categories in here. First one is, bet you can't name the full title.
I don't like that one.
That's plain.
It's a long title.
It's a long title, and sometimes there's like two parts of that. It's like something colon. And then something. So the whole thing.
I hate that title.
I have a bad idea, but it's a toughie. Next one. Today is June 23rd, 2012. You can pick the number one movie at the box office 10, 15, or 20 years ago. And third, let's go with our favorite, Vanilla Ice. Movies with vanilla or ice in the title. What do you like?
I like
party going on outside.
I like party.
No Venga Boys. No Venga Boys. You know the rules. No Venga Boys on podcast.
I will go 15 years ago.
Number one movie at the box office 15 years ago. I think you're both going to be pleasantly surprised.
Josh.
Nope, you are bad with dates.
Josh 3.
Yeah.
Correct.
You both win.
Wait, what was 15 years ago? 1994?
Very good. 15 years ago was 1997. This movie was given 2.5 stars by Leonard Maltin. 2.5 stars by my count, too many.
Those are always good ones.
Yeah. It has, why am I counting when I have it written down already, 12 actors in it, and let me tell you a little something about it. Can't say that. Can't say that. The lead actor is okay, but unremarkable as the main character. Ditto for the female. The action and effects are loud, gargantuan, and ultimately numbing. I'm debating whether to say one more thing about it, which would get the actor voting down from the high numbers to the low numbers. But I'm wondering. But it's spotlight two colorful villains. If that does anything.
No.
Okay. Well, I'm glad I said it then. It wasn't too much of a giveaway.
How many actors will we have?
12 actors. And I love the first act. Please just don't bet zero, because I'm so excited to read the first actor I get to read.
You mean on the bottom?
Yeah, I'm excited to read number 12.
Yeah, I'll say
12. Okay. P.S. The billing on this is stupid.
Leonard had a different view.
Than everyone who made it and watched it.
Well, he did give it 2.5 stars.
So. And he gave it 2.5 stars. He might not have watched this movie.
He might have watched something else and gotten confused.
Tell us of 11.
Out of 12.
Drew says 10.
9.
Episode 9.
9. How did I say Kelly named that movie?
You got a good shot. I'm going to say. Number 1, with a bullet, Coolio. Coolio was in the number 1 movie in America. How times have changed. Coolio. Vandella K. Thomason. Keeping up the middle initial streak. Vivica A. Fox. Elle McPherson. John Glover. Pat Hingle. Michael Gough. Gough. G-O-U-G-H. Nobody knows who he is. Doesn't matter. Alicia Silverstone, Uma Thurman. That's all you got. 9 out of 12. Top 3 are billed in stupid order. 2.5 stars, 1997, number 1 at the box office. Two colorful villains. Lead actor's okay as the main character. Ditto for the girl. Action effects are loud, gargantuan, and ultimately numbing.
Batman and Robin
says Kelly Summers. Point to Kelly Summers, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, wow.
Batman and Robin.
What was Coolio in that?
I don't know what Coolio was. You guys want to guess the top 3 villains?
Commissioner. I'm going to say...
George Clooney.
Schwarzenegger.
O'Donnell. Should be Clooney, O'Donnell, Schwarzenegger. Oh, it is
Schwarzenegger.
Schwarzenegger, Clooney, O'Donnell. Ooh. Arnold Schwarzenegger, the star of Batman and Robin.
Yeah, I don't think Leonard watched that movie.
Leonard did not watch this movie. Yeah. Can we agree that Leonard Maltin did not watch this movie?
He got too distracted by the nips.
You mean Arnold's nips? Oh, yeah, that was a suit with nipples. Well, that does give it... Okay, I'd say it's a 1-star movie. The nips give it an extra star and a half. That's legitimate.
I like my superheroes to be ass out of here. They have their costumes on.
Quit farting!
I can't help it. It's the chip. You have a disease.
Just stop eating the chip.
Well, that's easier said than done.
Then I'll take them away. You know what plays great on microphone? Eating. People love to hear that. Okay, let's go. The who told who the name? Drew told that you tell us the name, so Kelly chooses. Yeah. Best Picture Losers. 4-letter titles, because I'm one better than Drew. And winners of the Razzie for Worst Picture.
Razzie.
We get a choice between 2008, 2003, and
1996.
Ooh. 2008
was one?
Yeah, 08, 03, 96.
Going 08.
08. Fine choice.
Tell
the truth, sir. No, don't give him the chips. 2008, 2 stars. Way too many stars again.
This is a random winner.
I don't know. Again, Leonard may not have watched this.
Maybe he was drunk.
Maybe he's always
drunk. I'm a fucking king of movies.
Drunk Leonard Maltin, king of movies. We are looking at 11 actors. And what do we see? The star also co-wrote this silly little farce that has a few laughs, but is mostly filled with juvenile double entendres and recycled shtick from another famous movie the lead actor did that I don't want to say because that gives it away. And, yeah, that's absolutely all I can say about it. 2 stars, 2008, Razzie winner for Worst Picture. 11 actors, bid is to Kelly. And for whatever insane reason, the Leonard, Drunk Leonard, again, lists the genre as romance. If not, don't let that affect your pick in any way. It is a comedy, in theory. It's not funny, but it's a comedy. It is not a romance.
I think I know what it is, but I'm not sure if I'd be your right.
I'm not sure if I'd be
If you
right
think
right.
you know, go -3 and man up.
I don't know if I could go -3.
I don't know.
I could -1.
I can maybe go -3.
If you know the movie, you can easily go -1, yeah. And then maybe 2. It's a toss-up who number 2 is. Anyway, I've said too much. Floor is the count.
I'll go with -1.
Ooh. Kelly, manny up. Drew, if you think you know it, can you go -2 or more? Because you may want to go -3 in case Kelly can do -3, so you might want to cut him off at the pass.
I don't get it right.
Send somewhere close to the microphone. You're in like another room.
If I don't get it right, then Kelly's up 2-0.
If you don't get it right, Kelly is indeed up 2-0. I like how you gave the first point to yourself on the scorecard.
Sorry, what the hell?
So sure that Kelly wouldn't get a point. Kelly scored it. Also, on Drew's official scorecard over here, I'd like to point out that you can't see on the initial Drew versus Scott Leonard Maltin game, I'm assuming just after Drew won, Drew wrote in the biggest letters on the page, Drew wins, niggers.
Hey, I gotta make sure that they know it's like that I won.
Jesus. So, keep that in mind as you'll see. So, bid is -1 to Drew.
For those of you scoring at home, don't cheer for me. I don't like the ethnics.
No, do not cheer for Drew.
Unless you don't like the ethnics. I gotta
fix Drew is your man.
I've got a big following in Alabama. I'm going to say...
Drew's numbers are huge in the first, so...
I'm going to say -2.
-2? Can you do 3? If you know the movie, you can name the top 3.
I can... I know more people in this movie.
Sure.
But in the movie, I can try -3.
Kelly's trying -3. Good fucking luck with -4. -4 made that movie.
God,
sorry. Drew, for those who can't see, Drew is in the most pain I have ever seen him in. And I have seen Drew punched in the face before.
You've kicked a rope in the face.
I have broken Drew's nose before. And
broke my nose.
I have broken 2 noses in not a lot of time. And Drew is in more pain than either of those nose breaking.
It's because Kelly took the chips away from me. That's why I'm in pain. Yeah, I need to feed my butt.
Yeah, Drew, about halfway through the podcast, Drew started putting the chips directly into his butt.
Sounds like that.
Moving out my mouth.
Moving out his mouth. You know what? Getting it in the order. I'm going to get real fucking baldy.
You are 100% dumb. -5 or name that movie. I so hope that you have, like, the entire movie wrong. You just start naming all these wrong actors.
Yeah.
It's pretty funny.
This isn't going to be Scream 2, Anna Faris.
Scream 2, Anna Faris. Anna Faris was in Scary Movie, you idiot.
All right, I'll say name it. Hey, Denver! Kelly says name it. Drew, 2008.
You can't tell me if I'm wrong until I...
I want to see if I can nail it.
Drew will name the movie, and all 4 actors build from first to fourth, and then and only then will I tell him if
I think I have a year old.
Right or wrong.
I'm definitely doubting myself now.
I am hoping upon hope, as I hope you're at home, that Drew has the entire movie wrong and is about to name the wrong movie and 4 wrong actors.
Okay, yeah. But I'm going to say that it is You Don't Mess With the Zohan, and the main actors are Adam Sandler, Emmanuel Shrieky, Tom Schneider, and Michael Buffer.
Drew, let me tell you that you are 100% incorrect. The movie is The Love Guru.
Oh, my God.
Kelly, would you care to name The Love Guru the actors in descending order?
If I could do... I don't know. I don't think I could get them in order, but I could do it with Mike Myers.
Yep.
Jessica Alba?
Yes.
Justin Timberlake?
Yes.
What's his name? The guy who
can Romany Malky.
No,
Romany Malky.
Yeah, him.
Yep, he's 4.
And then that.
You won't get 5.
No.
Negan Good. I don't remember who that even was. I was kept trying to think of that.
Then Vern Troyer, Ben Kingsley, Manu Narayan.
Really? Vern Troyer over Ben Kingsley?
Yep.
Vern, maybe me over Gandhi.
Yeah, that's right, telling me. John Oliver, Stephen Colbert, Jim Gaffigan.
Now, you see, I was definitely thinking of the Love Girl, but I thought maybe that was 2009.
Well played, Drew. That is 2 points for Kelly. Chick, go ahead. I want to see how it's ranked. I hope that Leonard didn't even review Zohan. You don't mess with the Zohan. 2.5 stars.
What?
You asshole drunk Leonard.
Yeah, yeah, I like that.
Zero. 2.5 stars. Sandler, Totoro, Emmanuel.
Totoro.
Swartzen, Nealon.
Really?
All of Sandler's assholes.
Not even like, where the fuck are all the other people?
Swartzen, Nealon, Lainey Kazan, Rob Schneider, Mariah Carey, Robert Smigel, Shelley Berman, Charlotte Ray, Chris Rock.
Not even Michael Buffer. He's the bad guy in it. He is the villain in that movie.
I, along with Drunk Leonard, don't care.
I'm going to go back and watch that.
However, I am going to give you partial credit in the form of 0 points.
We might have to watch
that. You got the year right. It was also 2008.
We might have to watch that movie.
Yikes, guys. But yeah, we probably will. 2 for 6. Kelly going for the win.
Yeah, I'm good.
See?
Yeah, no, well, actually, these last movies have been watched.
You're good against Drew.
Yeah.
So far, it's been destroyed.
It's almost been all shut up. You got 1 point against me.
That's right, yeah. 3-1 and 3-0 so far. And Kelly looking for another shut up. Let's go.
Water at me.
Let's go. Best Picture Losers. Movies nominated for, but not winning Best Picture. Movies I Love. And back to Bet You Can't Name the Whole Title.
You have a shitty category.
Yeah. Those were great categories, and how dare you?
How dare you?
Wait, can I tell me a name? That's my choice, right? Yes.
I always want to say movies that I love, because I always choose Billy Madison. It's already been chosen.
I
am going to say Best Picture Losers.
Those are three ones I don't like the most.
Fair.
So, from Best Picture Losers, now, for those who don't know, Drew has all the movies in the world, but all those movies in the world start at around 1990. So, that being said, here are your year choices.
I just eat my 80s.
Yes, amazing. Here are your year choices. 1979, 1976, or 1941?
41.
Them apples, comma, how do you like them? Oh, wait, that would be how do you like them, Ben Apple?
I'm an apple.
I would
say 1949.
41. Are you still okay with that?
79.
You sure you don't want to go with the 40?
I don't want to go with 41.
You've heard of movies.
I'm not, like, being...
Yeah, I've never seen it.
It's not some How Green Was My Valley shit.
Do you think I've seen any of them? At least one of the three. Between 1 and 3 of all three of them. So we're going to 79?
Yeah.
All right. Do it up! All right, your 1979 movie, 3.5 stars. Holy shit. I myself would give it probably either 3.5 or 4. Damn good movie. Probably should have won Best Picture over whatever one. Yes, it should have, actually, because I know what won that year. We have... Again, 79, 3.5 stars. We have how many actors in it? 13 actors.
The
13
monkeys.
The 13 monkeys. Kelly wins. 13 actors. Again, weird billing. Let's tell you something about it. Is that too much of a giveaway? It's based on a book. The film's conclusion is cerebral and murky. Still a great movie experience most of the way with staggering Oscar-winning photography. Reissued in 2001, who cares? There was a documentary made and released about the movie as well. I don't think I want to say the giveaway thing about it, so I won't.
I want to offer.
How many actors?
13.
13 actors.
12.
10.
11.
You went the... Oh, did you go up? Oh, you said
10. Oh, you said 10. I'm sorry. 9. Then.
I will say 8. You will say 8 out of 13.
Name it.
You definitely know some names in it.
Is it improper podcast etiquette to jump table and punch Kelly?
Oh, yeah, because if you don't get this, Kelly shuts you out.
Here's the thing. As soon as I heard those 3 years, I went with the only movie I knew from one of those 3 years and bet the farm on it.
Yeah, that's kind of what my sort of strategy was.
I love it. So you're getting 8 out of 13?
Yes.
Well, you'll know some names, but not these first ones. Colleen Camp, Tom Mason, Scott Glenn, Harrison Ford, G.D. Spradlin, Dennis Hopper,
my favorite bad guy,
Lawrence Fishburne,
a very young Lawrence Fishburne,
Larry Fishburne, if you will, and Sam Bottoms is all you.
Sam Bottoms, the second time you've heard Sam Bottoms' name.
Yes, he's gotten a lot more, he's got more play today than any day in the last 20 years.
Dennis Hopper, Lawrence Fishburne.
Very young elfish.
1979. I'm going to say this movie.
Nominated for and lost Best Picture. Probably should have won because it's better than what won.
Okay. Can I say the movie that I thought it won or should I say that after?
You can, as long as you make it clear that it's not your official answer, you can say whatever you want.
This is not my official answer.
Okay. It's on the front page.
1979 I could think of, and I bet the farm on was 80.
That's what I
that's exactly my
yes, right.
So good thing I didn't say -2.
I don't think a lot of those people are aliens.
I'm going to say the only movie I can think of that has Lawrence Fishburne that early on is Apocalypse Now.
You have continued this game.
Oh.
Well done.
What did they lose to?
Lost to Kramer vs. Kramer. I think
I've seen Kramer vs. Kramer.
It should have lost to Kramer vs. Kramer.
No, Kramer vs. Brother, I would not be complaining that it won.
I will say that Alien has an interesting bill according to some things. It is not Sigourney Weaver as number one star. It's Tom Skerritt.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that is weird.
Because originally he was supposed to be the hero of the movie.
Right.
And then they redid it so that she was the hero.
It's not Sigourney Weaver's underwear. Like,
yeah,
what a baby.
Oh, you get Top Gun.
I don't care what year it is, she's a babe.
And you've seen Apocalypse Now, have you?
I have.
Okay.
I like it.
I have.
So
I hate
who,
it.
Who would you go first?
Marlon Brando.
Oh, you would? Okay. Yeah. I'd do Martin Sheen first.
Yeah. Oh, I figure Martin Brando because,
well, he is.
Martin Brando's like the greatest actor considered by many of all time.
Yeah.
So other than him, Sheen, and then...
Can we agree that Marlon Brando didn't cement that opinion until the Island of Dr. Moreau?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dr. Duvall third?
Duvall second. Sheen third.
What the fuck?
I don't agree with that.
Drunk! He's a drunk man.
Drunk
man. But you know what? He was only drunk on the ones we've done today.
Yeah, because
the other ones that we haven't done today,
he's like one. Perfectly reasonable review, besides the ones we've done today.
The sequence of movies that he's reviewing is in the correct sequence that we are doing them, and he was drunk for that period.
Yeah, that's right. So point for two, it is not a shout-out for Kelly.
I can't believe it. I got that, but it's only the Lawrence Fishburne 1979. It's the only thing I can think of.
Folks, this may be a first and last. Drew got a movie from pre-1980.
Yeah.
Randall's back.
I could have done a flat shot. That's 1979.
All right, so...
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Apocalypse Now.
Well, you are...
Not a bad movie.
One of us is wrong.
It wasn't a bad movie, I just...
It is kind of long.
It's
2.5 hours, yeah.
But, yeah, I'm tired. All right.
Okay,
so Kelly.
No, because he'll
be there.
Okay, let's go with Mr. Anderson.
Wes.
The movies of Wes and or, actually just or, because they didn't make any together, Paul Thomas Anderson.
Okay, do I know who Paul Thomas Anderson is?
P.T. Yes.
Anderson.
P.T. Anderson. I can't really tell you
anything. Okay,
most of the
I'm sure I know him.
You do know him. You've definitely seen some or all of his movies. We'll go with Trois Couleurs. Or America, movies with red, white, or blue in the title. And let's go four-letter titles.
I will go with...
What was the first one again? First one was...
Anderson.
I will go with... Which one is a Matrix reference and not a stupid TNA reference?
That's correct.
I'm going to punch you.
I will go with...
America. America. America.
choice is America. You can have an American movie from 1999, 2004, or 1984. I'm going with 1999. I think that's the best choice.
1999.
Best choice as a movie or easiest to get?
What is the easiest to get?
Well, good, because I'm glad I chose that one. I'm trying to like, back up in this. But we'll see. Yeah, Drew's trying to claw the way back. Okay, so in 1999, with 2.5 stars, were eight actors. And let's tell you a little something about it, but I will have to spell it correctly.
No, I'm sorry.
I don't want your skin tab.
We don't have any feet for it.
It might be your feet.
We've got a pool on the table.
So, 1999, 2.5 stars, 8 actors. Let's talk about it. Can't say that, can't say that. Sometimes exciting combination of a movie from 1974 and a movie from 1979. Has some surprises, but terrible dialogue and a preposterous premise. Ronnie Cox appears unbilled. He is, I believe, an older British man.
Okay, is he related to
Kevin Cox? He is not related to Kevin and or Cal Cox. 8 actors, 2.5 stars, 1999, has red, white, or blue in the title.
I will say 8. 9? 8. 8.
Is your math?
I'll say 8.
Drew says it.
If I say 9, can you give me the director as well?
I would be happy to. 6. I will tell you, you probably don't know the director.
Okay, I'm going to throw in there anyway.
I'll take 6. 6 of 8. Name it.
Fuck you. You piece of shit.
Fuck! I'm going to say...
I get it.
You might climb all the way back.
You may claw his way back.
I'm going to say 6 is the minimum you could get it in.
Thanks.
If it was 5, I think you'd be fucked. So we'll see. Aida Turturro.
Related to Aida.
LL Cool J. Stellan Skarsgård. Drew has a face.
I know this. Yes, I'm back in the game.
Michael Rapaport.
I'm going to stop you right there.
Jacqueline McKenzie.
A shark ate me, nigga. He ate me.
Damn.
Oh, he blew teeth.
L. Jackson. Drew has tied it to a piece. Deep Blue Sea. Cool J gave away?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Who's number one, Tom Jane? Or no, in the check, I guess. Let me go back to Tom Jane. Tom Jane, Saffron Burroughs. Whose name I couldn't tell you, couldn't have told you for $1 million.
Nope. Yeah. Can you even name another movie she's in?
Nope. Born Identity. Good for you. Run Lola Run. Not to be confused with Run Ronnie Run, which is a stupid David Cross movie. It's all right.
Yeah. Fine, I guess.
It's, they, like, Bob and David have, like, disowned that movie, though, because it felt, like, edited to shit.
All I remember is
really getting drunk and hiding under a kiddie pool.
Yeah. Turning the pool upside down and hiding under it.
So we're 2 apiece for the win. Sudden death, folks. Who is picking?
Me.
Drew is picking. Let's go. Number one box office 10 or 20 years ago, Movies I Love, or Two Dicks, the films of Alan Tudyk.
Ooh.
Not Buddy Cop films.
Not Buddy Cop films, which is the other thing Two Dicks could be.
Or I could think of a couple others.
Brought back around.
I'm going with the Alan Tudyk.
I love his work.
Well, there are a lot of Alan Tudyk movies, so maybe you have...
It is not a lot.
He's in that one where Catherine Heigl gets pregnant.
That's great.
Anyway, your 2 year choices are 05 and 07.
I will go with 07.
07, the mosquito. There is a mosquito in the studio. 2007, 3 stars, 12 actors. So Leonard liked it. 12 people did it. I'm going to keep talking about it until I search it up here. And here we go. Let's talk about it. overlong but often hysterically funny comedy is also sweet, romantic, and despite the exceedingly foul-mouthed dialogue, downright moral. Written by the director, numerous celebrities appear as themselves. Ooh. Unrated version also available. So keep that in mind. We'll see how that plays.
Not what I thought it was. At all.
Not what you thought it was. And all we know about it is that Alan Tudyk is in it. It's from 2007. Has 3 stars and 12 actors. The bidding starts with Jer.
I'll say all actors.
All of the actors. That would be 12. To Kelly.
11.
11. Back to Jer.
10.
Kenny says 9. Getting down it. 9 of 12.
To end the game, I will say name it.
Okay. It is up 9 of you, 12. Kelly. Kelly, it is in it to win it. We're doing 9 of 12?
Oh, it was a Bring It On movie? Damn it!
What?
Oh, he said in it to win it. That's a Bring It On movie, so I have it in?
No.
Damn it.
With a 9 or 8, that would do. A 9. I'm quite drunk.
No. 9 of 12. You want to involve that?
I'm all in bed.
Hang on, I'm all in bed.
Reading from the bottom up. Bill Hader. Kristen Wiig. Alan Tudyk. The aforementioned Tudyk. Jonah Hill, Joanna Kearns, Canadian-born Jay Baruchel, Harold Ramis, Jason Segel, we're doing 9 of 12?
Yeah.
Leslie Mann.
This could be one of any Judd Apatow movies.
Yeah.
It could be 9 movies.
2007, 3 stars. Overlong, but often hysterical funny comedy, is also sweet romantic, and despite the extremely foul-mouthed dialogue, downright moral, written by the director. Has Alan Tudyk in it, as we have established. Kelly, it's to you.
The one thing that's throwing me off is Jason Segel.
That was me. I'm not helping you. I'm playing against you. I don't want to help you.
He's writing
it. He faced the scorecard.
Yeah, yeah, I don't like it.
He's written.
I don't appreciate that.
Kelly is a nigger. We are losing listeners. If anyone stuck around this long, buy the truckload.
Okay, the next person that's listening to this is Alex because he loves it too much.
Hopefully Alex loves us, and hopefully Dan doesn't listen to the beginning of it. Hopefully Dan listens to it. He starts about 10 minutes in. Friend of the show, Dan for that.
End of the show, Christopher Lambert.
Yes.
Could we get Christopher Lambert on this? I would love that.
We try. Like, I don't know. This is episode 1. Are we going to get Christopher Lambisode on episode 1?
That could be only 1.
But, I don't know. I figure in the first 10 we can get Lambert.
He's not doing anything.
Yo, Raiden, what's up?
Hey, guy from Ghost Rider 2.
Kelly, you've had a long time to think about this.
Yes, I have. There's one movie in my mind, but
I
don't think it's worth
it. I thought, go with your gut.
Because there's so many things throwing me off now.
Tell me what's throwing you off, and I will not respond to that.
Yeah, Jason Segel's throwing off and the celebrity cameos. Did he mean celebrity cameos, like, as themselves?
Yes, numerous celebrities appear as themselves.
Yeah, that's what's throwing me off.
If it should be, maybe it shouldn't be. What do you look down from?
Anyway,
Drew knows what it is. Which does not help someone who isn't sure what it is.
I should have zero names.
Is it Knocked Up?
Fuck!
It is the aforementioned movie
that I accidentally named
where Catherine Heigl has a baby. Yep. It is Knocked Up. Kelly wins because Alan Tudyk is her boss.
Alan Tudyk is her boss. The celebrity cameos are because Catherine Heigl is a newswoman and celebrity
gay. So it's like hanging
off. Or no, she's like,
oh, yeah.
Look at this.
Yeah, it is.
Well, at first I was thinking super bad. But then you said all the celebrity cameos, and I'm like, I can't think of anything than Jason Segel that threw me off. And I'm like, Harold Ramis. I'm like, the only movie I can think of Harold Ramis is like I have seen recently was Knocked Up.
Not Ghostbusters.
He was Zimmerman's dad.
Yeah, exactly. So I was like,
yeah. Now, can we just
have shit heads for the sake of
it. Oh, yeah, absolutely. That's going to wrap it up for this. I hope you enjoyed episode one. Hopefully there will be future episodes, and hopefully you will listen to future episodes. We may have friends of the show, Justin Chu and Daniel Fedak, and even maybe Christopher Lambert on future episodes. So until next time, does Drew have a... Oh, Drew's taking.
You already know yours.
I have one I want to close with, so I'm waiting for you.
This is Channel 32 here.
What? Oh. Yeah, Channel 32.
The one that has a certain wrestling organization on it.
Oh, fucking Spike TV is a
shithead.
The next time Spike TV is a shithead?
Let us bolt the shithead. Those reviews.
That was my closer. I was gonna say Drunk Leonard Maltin is a shithead, so instead I would say Alex McConnell is a shithead. Calling you out, you limey fuck. See you next time.